story of a young lady who gets accused of something that she hasn't done and tried and convicted for that crime. And the crime's murder and the sentence is life. And it's about her husband who doesn't believe that she's capable of doing that. And really has to face the reality of what they're going to go through from now on. You know, they reach the end of the appeal process. So either he accepts that that's his life and her life from now on, or he tries to do something about it. And as he has exhausted all of the legal possibilities, illegal ones are the ones left to him. Well, it's an extraordinary situation, isn't it? You know, marriage under a great deal of pressure, and you know, the main thing for me, the thing that I responded to when I read the script, is that I just thought that the simple adventure of it, you know, that there is an undying love, and a man will do anything for his wife, and the conundrum, you know, to achieve what he achieves, he has to turn into somebody that his wife couldn't love. You know, so that to me was an interesting journey to go on. This is a very simple bloke. You know, he's an English teacher at a community college, and this situation has come crashing into an otherwise relatively placid life that the two of them are leading with their young child. He doesn't have the resources to be in this sort of situation. He certainly doesn't have the financial resources to pursue a case for over 3 years. So, yeah, I mean, this is a large turn of events, and really it's just the measure of their love that actually fuels the story from then on. I thought with this particular project that the process of auditioning should hold true, and the person that, you know, wins on the day should get the gig, and it was Elizabeth Banks. Brian Dennehy plays my father, and we've got a number of cool little turns from people. Liam Neeson plays a man who has escaped prison a lot, and Daniel Stern plays my attorney. So that's been a fun thing for me, that every week or so somebody new comes along, I get to do a scene with somebody who I respect and whose work I enjoy. I really like Crash. It's a great movie, you know, so that's an excellent calling card. You know, we had a conversation in London, and I think we talked for about an hour and a half or 2 hours, and we didn't agree on anything that we discussed. And that's usually a pretty good indicator. That's probably the person I'm going to go work with. Paul Haggis is directing the film. He directed Crash in the Valley of Ella. You know, there's a lot of narrative detail in this piece. I think actually the script is 394 scenes, which is unusual. There's another script shooting in town, and they were heard complaining that they've got such a, you know, a lot of work to do because they have 180 scenes to do. But you know, you've got to have a mind and an eye for a complex narrative if you're going to take on something like this. And you know from Paul's work as a writer, whatever piece it happens to be, complexity in the narrative is one of his specialties. So it's, it was just, you know, a situation for me where I read it. I really believed that it would make a great film, and, you know, a few weeks later I was on the way to Pittsburgh. Unlike a lot of the films that shoot in Pittsburgh, this script was actually written with Pittsburgh in mind. So the geography of Pittsburgh and the cityscape and the bridges and tunnels and the Allegheny County Jail are all, you know, heavily featured in the actual writing. So, that's where we are, and we've been here for the last 12 weeks, and I've had a really good time here, man. You know, it's a very friendly place.